feature this week from the city of Pasadena, California. The Rose Bowl, located in an area that was once dominated by an unruly barranca, it is now an area of recreation for the city and the location of one of the most famous sports arenas in the world. It is the home of the top-ranked UCLA Bruins, who today will meet the Washington State Cougars in Pac-10 conference action. The Bruins are 4-0 in the Pac-10 standings. USC, the other unbeaten. Washington State, 1-3 in the Pac-10, 4-3 overall, so all of their losses have been in the conference. Hello again, everybody. I'm Keith Jackson, along with Bob Greasy. Happily, I got to drive to work again this week. Bob gets to fly another 9 hours, but he's young. He can handle it.
All right. Ball is completing 71% of his passes from a spread formation utilizing three wide receivers and one running back. 500 yards in total offense, 38 points per game they're averaging. For UCLA and Troy Aikman, as we see UCLA coming onto the field. But Troy Aikman is averaging 40 points a game for the UCLA offense, and five times this year he's thrown for three or more touchdowns in a ball game.
All right, if you compare these two teams just offensively, and that's all, they come off relatively even. But there is one area of the game where UCLA has a most decisive edge, and that's on the defensive side of the ball.
Well, UCLA defensively is number one in the Pac-10 in scoring defense. Washington State is last, dead last, and therein is the problem. For the Cougars to win today, Rosenbach is going to have to keep his offense on the field and protect his defense. UCLA just needs to protect Troy Aikman and give him some time.
That's right. When you have a ball game in the Rose Bowl, it's almost like a festival. That's part of the way of life when you have the kind of climate you do around this part of the country. In a very pretty setting, and the folks come early because it's kind of a hard place to get in and out of, especially when you've got the big crowd. And so they come armed with picnic baskets, crystal, a little vino, flowers, babies, tents, motorhomes. A point of the whole thing is to make a day of it and enjoy it. And they know how to do it. Around the Rose Bowl in Pasadena. The Cougars and the Bruins coming up.
Hey! UCLA!
The series record between two teams decided edge for UCLA. Bruins won big in 86. 1958 was the last time that Washington State won a game down here. And would you believe I did that game? And Washington State won the toss, and they want the ball, so they will receive it to start the ball game with Victor Wood, 13, and Ed Kingstad, number 11, deep. They are without Steve Broussard, their top running back. He is home with a sprained ankle. Kirk Maggio will kick it off for the UCLA Bruins. Beautiful day. It was expected to be cool and rainy-like, but it's turned out to be a lovely day in Southern California. Kickoff by Maggio. Oh my gosh, don't bring it out of there. I thought for a minute he was going to come 6 yards deep out of the end zone. That'll stop your heart.
Yes, sir.
Dennis Erickson, second year at Washington State. You notice that Wyoming is having huge success this year. Well, he came over from Wyoming, and a lot of the young people that are playing at Wyoming with their unbeaten team were brought there by Dennis Erickson. From the 20 then, Washington State will go to work, Tim Rosenbach, and they work out of a single back offense. Rich Swinton, who grew up in Canoga Park in the San Fernando Valley, is the lone remaining back. They have trips to the bottom of the screen and they run it with Swinton, who had 193 yards last week against Arizona State, and he picked up seven on that carry. So this is the way the Cougars line up offensively. Rosenbach, the quarterback, Stallworth, and Wood with Wimberly, wideouts. Pelham plays a lot out there, too. Here are the big people that make this offense go. Well set, Husby, Mahojic, Takuma, Utley, and Dyko.
Second and three.
Pretty good offensive front. Second down and three now for Washington State. And here's your first move by the quarterback. Pass is dropped down in the middle, caught with a tight end, well set. And Washington State has a first down at midfield. These are the people who have to defend this wide-open Washington State offense now for UCLA, and they're good ones. Lotish, Waller, and Mayer are the down people up front. with Lake, Johnson, Davis, and Smith. That's about as good a core of linebackers as you're going to find. Henley, Turner, Darby, and Turner. That's Eric and Marcus. That is an outstanding defensive secondary. They really run to the ball. Rosenbach throws again. Pass is caught by Stallworth. And Stallworth, a 5'11", 170-pound junior from Pacoima, California. Stallworth and Swinton both went to high school in Montclair Pep in the Van Nuys area. So they are literally playing at home today.
Play action holds the linebackers. Stallworth just looks to the inside. The first three plays, three different formations for the Cougars. The first play was four wide receivers and no tight ends. The second play, two tight ends and only two wide receivers. Moving it around.
It is third down and about five, a loss on that previous play, and they send Tingstad in motion now. Rosenbaugh, a little quick pop, and the pass is incomplete to Stallworth. Stallworth was uncovered on the play, and he just stood up and popped the ball right to him, and he didn't get it to him, and it brings up a fourth down. So the Cougars, after moving the ball well, are stalled here. One on the drop by, or the literally a bad pass by Rosenbaugh, a little too quick. And the run by Swinton, in which he was brought down by Chance Johnson. This is, they're going to still go for the field goal. It's on 48 yards now. 48. Wind is not a factor. Got enough leg on it. Oh, he split it. So, Jason Hansen shows a leg. The freshman hits one from 48 yards. That is his longest ever. And now Coach Terry Donahue. His team is ranked first in the nation, first time in his 13 years at Westwood. And he frankly admits that he likes it. But he looked like he was walking on eggshells all week. Brian Brown, back healthy, joins Sean Wills. We've got two tailbacks now, deep for UCLA, and Brown is quite an addition to that offensive arsenal. Jason Hansen will kick it off for Washington State. The Cougars leading off their first possession on a 48-yard field goal, 3-0. It's a very, very high kick and taken up around the 13-yard line by Sean Wills, and he comes blasting out across the 30. 31-yard line for UCLA, their first possession. Turn around and give it to the tailback. It's Eric Ball, and Ball will have a couple of yards as he tries to slide off the right side. Offensively for UCLA, Aikman, obviously your quarterback. Estwick is beginning to really show his colors as a good fullback. Ball will be alternating some today with Brown and Wills. Mike Farr, one of the wideouts, and he's the leading pass catcher. Randy Austin, a bit of a surprise starter at tight end, but Corey Anthony has a sore ankle. On second down and eight, Aikman drops back to throw and goes underneath to the tailback, Eric Ball, and Eric is out to the 45-yard line, and he has a first down. Here's where the Washington State Cougars have had their trouble with their defensive people. Four down, Gray Ledbetter, Savage, and Cook. They've been dinged a lot in the defensive unit and particularly among the linebacking core. And today the backers are Metcalf, Rice, and O'Neal. The defensive secondary, Landrum, Lee, Holmes, and Vernon Todd. Ball now just on the UCLA side of midfield after that holding penalty. And Aikman back, looks up the middle, takes off. He can run. And he's inside the 35. To the 34. So a good gain by Troy Aikman as the center of the field opened up for him. And here's Bob Greasy to tell you why it opened up.
One of the things that Washington State tries to do with their defense is loop their linebacker, their lineman. They twist, see the outside man. Cook goes to the inside. Savage comes to the outside. And when you do that, there creates some holes up the middle. The linebackers need to be there to make the tackles, and that time they were.
That's the longest Aikman run of the year, and Estwick, the fullback, picked up the outside man and made that play work. This is Eric Ball.
Ball
just about the line of scrimmage, and that's all he's going to get. It is fourth down, and Alfredo Velasco is into the ball game. He's going to try one, and he'll kick it out of Kirk Maggio's hole, and it'll be 47 yards. Hansen hit a 48-yarder in the first possession for Washington State. Now it's Velasco's turn to answer. And it just got over. Just squeezed. Cougars did over. At 1:32 to go in the first quarter, and we're tied at 3. All right, UCLA with a 47-yard field goal by Alfredo Velasco ties Washington State at 3-3 with a minute and 32 seconds to go in the first quarter. Kurt Maggio will kick it off. It'll be Victor Wood and Ed Tingstad, the deep people, for Washington State. Last time Kurt kicked it, he kicked it about 6-8 yards deep into the end zone. The two quarterbacks, we figured they'd be the dominant personalities, and so far they have been. This time Maggio hits a line drive that's going to go in and out of the end zone, and it'll come back to the 20. Ball having come back to the original line of scrimmage where it is third down and 10. Well, he's checking off and he better hurry up because he's going to run out of time again. Rosenbaugh's pass is caught by Stallworth, but he steps out at the 29 and that's short of the first down. So it'll bring up fourth and in comes the punting team. And here goes Darrell Henley, the most dangerous of the dangerous when it comes to this particular play.
His
return broke one in the Nebraska game.
Right, and he had one other one. He's returned two punts for touchdowns already.
All right, Rob Myers will punt. Henley standing back. Inside is 35. It's a good hanger, sort of a knuckleball, and forces Henley that time to make a fair catch at the 39. I'll tell you what, if you're going to control Henley, that's probably as good a thing as you do is kick it as high as you can and make him fair catch it with good coverage. Second down and 8. You're at the Rose Bowl, a 3-3 tie, and the clock winding down, and they're going to let it die at the end of the first quarter. So after the first 15 minutes between these two potent offensive teams, it is a 3-3 tie. Here in Pasadena, California, the Rose Bowl. We've got a 3-3 tie after one quarter of play. Washington State, UCLA. Farr and Keating wide outs with Estrick and Ball. No, it's Brown lined up behind Troy Aikman. Ryan Brown. Very good pass receiver. He's out protecting Aikman. Troy pulls it down and takes off for the second time in the ball game. And he picks up the first down for UCLA as he gets it over on the Cougar side of the field.
Let's take a look at the first quarter stats. The total number of plays for each team was dead even. Total yardage for Washington State was 114 to 67. Of course, Washington State had the one turnover, the fumble, and the penalties in the first quarter, 7.
Down the middle, Arbuckle. And Charles Arbuckle inside the 15.
One of the weaknesses of that defense, as you look at Arbuckle making it back after missing 4 games, Arbuckle is right here. He's just released to the inside and run a curl. Now Grayson, the middle linebacker, or this linebacker here, has to get back and play. He's just going to curl right in between the two of them. Play action fake to hold the linebackers. Arbuckle turns away from the most dangerous one, Grayson to the inside. Nice play.
And first down, Washington State 13-yard line. Into the middle goes Mark Estwick, 225-pound sophomore from La Cañada, which is not very far from the Rose Bowl. Hits, and it seems almost every week he's pounding in there with more authority.
Well, man pounding in the center, 68, is Carnish. To his right is Zeno, number 79. They do a nice job of blowing back the nose tackle. There's a look at Frank Cornish.
That's a pancake, isn't it? And back into the game comes Alfredo Velasco, the place kicker. He's kicked a 47-yarder by the hair of his chinny-chin-chin a little while ago. I mean, it just barely got over. This one is 23. And it's 20 good. So he is 25 out of 26 field goals inside 44, and he just added another one to that list. Well, so far, it has not been a scintillating day for Troy. Twice now, they've had the ball down inside the Washington State 15, and they've come away with field goal. And I frankly find that surprising for them.
Well, this style of defense that the Cougars play, they gamble a lot. They twist their line, they take a lot of chances, and they can make you look bad a lot of times, but you have to be patient, because if you hit them at the right time, you can look very good.
What a week. All right, the kickoff by Maggio goes inside the five, where it's bobbled around by Tingstad. Now he falls down back at the nine. So that wasn't a particularly graceful return.
But the style of offense that the Cougars employ, you would think that they would throw more than they run. It's not necessarily the case. Here today, they've run nine plays and have thrown the ball eight. They get more out of a one-back running attack. Never seen of any team.
All right, here they come up on first down from the nine, and Rosenbach has good protection and throws it poorly. The pass intended for Wellsant is tied in, and he threw him a bullet that he couldn't haul in, and he threw it actually beyond him.
Well, they were fortunate it wasn't picked off because it was batted around.
All right, Rob Myers needs the punt of his life right here because Daryl Henley's waiting to return it, and he's on the Cougar side of midfield. It's a low snap. There's no pressure. Penalty flag down. High, short kick. Fair catch, Henley, at the 42. Bob, I have the feeling that when you're sitting in this position, first down on the opposition 42-yard line, and you've been kind of wobbling around, good football teams now stick in the end zone.
Especially when they haven't scored in the previous two drives. But you went to one of these schools, didn't you? Weren't you up in the Washington State at one time? Aren't you a Cougar?
I'm a Cougar.
Huh?
I wish that hairstyle had come back. You could scratch your head.
You look good, though. You're an outstanding athlete, somebody was telling me up there.
Huh? Here I was. Running from house to the bookstore and back. Good throw, good catch by Mike Farr, out of bounds, down at the 27 or 8.
28 yards.
And that'll be a first down for the Bruins. UCLA leading 6-3 with 9 minutes to go in the first half. It was 3-3 after the first quarter, and Velasco with a second field goal, giving the Bruins their lead. Ledbetter is now back in the game for Washington State. From the 28, Toy is in at fullback for the Bruins now, Maura Toy. Aikman throwing again. Keating makes the catch on the sidelines. David, a junior out of Salinas. And the Bruins now have the football, first and goal at the Washington State 9.
Aikman did a nice job of looking to his left and then comes back and finds Keating. See, he looks away to his left and then comes all the way back to this side of the field, has the presence of mind to know where his receiver should be, finds the defensive men and throws between them. Now he's completed passes to six different receivers.
Eric Ball inside the five and brought down at the four. 57, Keith Rice, the middle linebacker, makes the play for the Cougars.
Look defensively. Metcalf, number 40, is getting blocked. He's their leading tackle. He's on the ground, and on the ground good as Zeno, 79, finishes him off.
Second and goal for the Bruins from the Cougar 4. Aikman rolls it out. Don going to go for it himself and just misses the corner. He's about 6 inches short of the goal line as he literally flew through the air and out of bounds.
It's so important to have a quarterback that can move and just put so much more pressure on the defense. And Aikman and Rosenbach both have the ability to move around.
UCLA trying to score the first touchdown of the day in the ball game. They've got Eric Ball now back in there behind Estwick. Estwick. Touchdown, UCLA. Go in for the extra point try now. Maggio gets a good snap and the kick is good. And 7:49 to go in the first half. UCLA Bruins now lead by 10.
Ooh-wee. Hoosiers haven't quit, have they?
My
goodness.
Mark Esper. Big Mark getting the Bruins touchdown. And 13-3. Here's a new kick returner for the Cougars now. That's C.J. Davis. He is a true freshman, but instead Victor Wood takes it and breaks it outside and gets up across the 25 out to the 27-yard line. Rosenbach in trouble. Sack back at the 20, and it is Mike Lodish getting the sack. Took a deep drop, and that gave Lodish some room to work.
That was a bootleg action, and he came out, was supposed to have fooled the defensive line. He didn't fool Lodish as he gets his third sack of the year. Look at the top. The offensive line pull, that's the counterplay. Lodish did not follow the offensive lineman down, contained very nicely, and got the sack.
Here goes Henley again. Ever dangerous with that ball in the air. Myers back to punt. Myers has punted twice, 32 and 30. This time he gets something on it. Runs Henley all the way back to the 11. And the Cougars get him at the 13. Michael Wright ran him down. So that, after two relatively weak punts by Myers, he knocks one 55 yards. The return is 3 yards.
Possession.
First down, just over their own 35. Aikman throwing again, has Moore down the middle, and Moore will get to the 42. Pickup of about 7 yards. Dan Grayson got the tackle for Washington State, and we're at 5:45 to play in the first half. UCLA leading Washington State 13-3. Ball and Estrick lined up now behind Aikman on third and one. Aikman still got it, wanted to go big with it. Instead, unloads it out to the tight end, Austin. And Randy Austin is finally pulled down at the Washington State 23. Big guy, 225-pound sophomore, and he just kept on hammering, and finally Artie Holmes was able to wrestle him down.
The good call, Steve Axman, the offensive coordinator. You're on the other team's side of the 50. It's a nice time to go for it on third and short. And a man going deep, the coverage was deep, but the outlet receiver, Austin, was wide open. Maybe you saw.
Second down and 8 with Toy in the backfield for the Bruins. In the middle. And it's the fullback. Maura Toy making the catch, and I mean there was not a white shirt within 5 yards of it.
Aikman does a nice job of getting away from the rush. There's a little twist now. Number 90 is Woodley. He backs up, he knows he needs just a little bit more time. If you didn't follow the ball, you saw that Aikman took Woodley out of the play. He just kind of buried himself with Woodley, but it was a nice play.
Danny Thompson comes in and brings the play, number 15. He steps up into a slot. Give it to Aikman, keeps it, throws it. Back of the end zone, touchdown, Thompson.
senior, has not played very much because of all the other tailbacks. A nice fake into the line of scrimmage to the lower right of your screen. Thompson, number 15, catches his third pass of the season and his third touchdown pass of the season.
UCLA now trying to make it a 20-3 ball game with Velasco in. And he does. 2:15 to play in the first half. That is the eighth different receiver to catch an Aikman pass. Another look at it. Good fake.
It's fake, and I think if I were the defensive team, I'd keep somebody on Thompson. He's caught three passes and three for touchdowns. He only plays when he gets inside the five-yard line. He's that motion back. He's a good receiver, a good blocker. He's an intelligent kid. He's a senior. He's been around the program. I'd keep an eye on him if I were the defense.
All right, Maggio kicks it off, and Kirk really nails this one way up in the air, and that affords you good coverage. Victor Wood, number 13, looking for a crack. And he gets a little, but not enough, as he comes down, crashing to the ground at the 25-yard line.
Mark McGill makes the tackle.
So now let's see if the Cougars can generate some offense, because the UCLA defensive people just haven't given them much opportunity here in the last couple of possessions.
On their own 25.
It's time for Rosenbach to make something happen. The last three possessions, three plays and out.
You won't beat this UCLA bunch with a tango offense, will you?
1-2-3 kick, huh?
Down the middle, got a man. Pass good to the 40-yard line, caught by Tim Stallworth. He plays in that slot back position, called slot back in this offense. Simply means wideout. Gotta hurry. Boy, there comes that outside speed. Carnell Lake and Doug Klein, 31 and 48.
Anytime you come to the line of scrimmage, you've got to see somebody lined up like that. He's just going to come from the outside. He looks away from him, never sees him coming.
That time it is Eric Schmidt. Eric finally getting some vindication after getting hit with a 15-yard personal foul for taking him out of bounds. This time Smith also came from the outside.
Anytime.
Hanson is in now. He had a 48-yarder. This one is a 51-yard try.
1 yard field goal.
51-yarder. A lot of leg. Oh, good.
UCLA 20.
Style of offense
State
the Cougars have been used to. They usually scoring touchdowns and not settling for field goals, but great kick.
I mean, he not only kicked it 51 yards good, but that ball went, it was up around the top of the uprights when it went through. I bet he kicked that thing 65 yards.
Well, he hit it good. He knew he hit it good, and he just needed to check the direction, and immediately, that's in slow motion, he knew it was good immediately.
And at halftime, the top-ranked team in the country, the UCLA Bruins, lead the Washington State Cougars 20-6. Right now, let's go to our studios in New York and Corey McFerrin.
What do you think about this first half of play?
Well, I think the two quarterbacks are the highlight performers going in. I think Troy Aikman has done very well. He's passed for over 150 yards, rushed for 40, almost 200 yards. He's leading his offense the way he wants to. I think Rosenbach, on the other hand, is having more problems. Of course, he's going up against a tougher defense in UCLA's. He's got to play better in the second half. He's got to avoid the sacks, see the blitz coming, and know where to go with the football. If Washington State's got a chance to win, he's got to play well.
Well, he's had some guys open, and he just simply hasn't hit them, too. So he's really got to bear down here and hustle himself back into the ball game as the Bruins lead by 14, and we're ready to go with the second half. Well, some of the fun at halftime there. As we get ready to go with the second half, Washington State will kick off to UCLA. Bruins ranked number one in the country. And leading 20-6 at halftime. Brian Brown and Sean Wills are deep, standing at the goal line for the UCLA Bruins. And kicking off, Jason Henson. who has kicked two big field goals for the Cougars, 48 and 51 yards. Keeps that kickoff low, though. It's at the about a yard deep in the end zone. Sean Wills getting a chance to run with it, and he can run. Bruins have two touchdowns coming in the first half, well, after two field goals. Here is the first one. That's Mark Estrup, the fullback, over the top for their first touchdown. And the second one came through the air. As Troy Aikman faked, throws him, lobs it into the back of the end zone, and Danny Thompson pulled it down. And the Bruins will start just over their 28, first down, first snap of the second half. Aikman, been busy today, shoots it to the sideline, passes good to Randy Austin. Now let's check in with Mike Adamley.
Well, at least, Keith, for Dennis Erickson, the key to this second half is what they can do offensively. Tim Rosenbach is going to have to eat up a little more time on the clock. You looked at the defensive linemen, especially for Washington State. They were really beat up. A lot of that problem was because they were on the field so long. That can't happen in the second half for the Cougars to have any kind of a chance. Keith?
Thank you, Michael. 35-yard line. Second down and four. And the fullback, Estwick, gets it and picks up a first down for the Bruins at the 40. The halftime stats.
Well, at the bottom of the screen, the time of possession, that's what Mike Adamley was talking about, almost two for one for UCLA. Number of plays, UCLA leads, and also total yardage, 237 yards in the first half for UCLA. And a lot of that came in the second quarter.
And plus five penalties on the Cougars, five sacks, and one fumble. First down, Bruins. Eric Ball. Big hole left side. And Eric Ball explodes to the Washington State 46.
In the second quarter, UCLA really took charge, holding the ball for nearly 11 minutes and outscoring the Cougars 17-3.
And Aikman now on first down looks to load it up, throws it low, and give a catch to Reggie Moore. All right, the penalty tacked on puts UCLA first and goal just inside the Cougar 9. And they're running the ball well to start the second half as Eric Ball blows it in. Touchdown.
Watch the blocking here. It's a tight end's going to come and double team down here. The fullback is going to kick out on this block. It'll be a nice hole. The guard is going to get knocked off. He's not even going to make it out there, but they really don't need him. Tight end doubles down. Fullback gets a nice block. And good, tough running.
And Velasco against Troy. Right on the money. So, the opening possession. And UCLA bounds out to a 27-6 lead. Not counting possessions to run out the half, UCLA has scored five consecutive times. They had the two field goals. Now they've got three touchdowns, and they lead 27-6. And they are threatening to slam the door on this one unless the Cougars can give Rosenbaugh and company some field position off this kickoff, and they can get it on down the field.
Well, they've scored 28 points in every game, at least 28 in every game they've played, and they're averaging 38. So going up a little bit different defense here than they faced all year.
Sure, this Bruin defense is much tougher. Great speed. That's a high, high kickoff. And it goes to Victor Wood. And Wood gets back to the 21, and that's all. So Tim Rosenbaugh now, happy with a clean football, steps up. First down, 46-yard line for the play-action fake. Looks down the middle, late getting it there, but it's complete, and Stallworth slides away, and a penalty flag. So let's look here. Might be a face mask, and it is, and it's against UCLA, and probably inadvertent.
Stallworth is coming over the middle.
Incidental face mask.
It's Turner, number 24.
First down.
Gets away from that and picks up some good yardage before Johnson knocks him out of bounds.
Incidental grabbing of the face mask, that is to grab and release, and unintentional is only a 5-yard penalty versus the 15 for twisting it. And that gives Washington State now a first down at the UCLA 29-yard line. And he's now past 2,000 yards on the season. Formation call from the sideline. There's that little quick pop, and it's caught. Brought in by number 36, Elmer Thomas, senior from Dallas, Texas. And he moves the ball from the 29 to the 21.
When you spread everybody out here like this, you've got the defensive end. The thing you're not prepared to do is block these blitzers from both sides. The thing you can do, however, is throw the ball quickly. Two outside guys come. They don't have time, but he gets rid of it. That time he avoided the sack and made a positive play.
Second down. About 9. Rosenbach down the middle. Stallworth at the 5 to the goal line. Touchdown. He's a fighter.
Great effort. There he is right here. Stallworth is going to go down to the inside. The linebacker is going to come out as, again, they're blitzing. Rosenbach sees it. He doesn't have a lot of time. The man sees the blitz. He comes to the inside, breaks the tackle by Turner, and makes a great effort to get in for the touchdown.
Jason Hansen is in for the extra point. Darrell Henley came flying in there, and almost got a piece of that one, but the kick is good. Effort of Stallworth here as he fights away from the 5, and he got the last 5 on his own. 27-13. Well, Stallworth's got a touchdown in the books, but I will show you the replay of it, and it could have been called down short, but it wasn't. The kickoff, Goodwin back into the end zone, and they're going to come with it. It is Sean Wills. Sean getting a chance to run a little, and he's going to take that chance, but this time it was probably poor judgment because he is stopped short of the 14-yard line. Here's the Stallworth touchdown.
His right knee. Watch his right knee. He's going to be down right there. Now, the ball should have been marked there about the yard and a half yard line. Both officials are looking at the ball to see if he gets in.
Knee is clearly down.
Yeah.
Second and 4, it's Eric Ball. Cuts it back inside, big hole for him, drops the ball. Cougars may have it. Yes, they do. So the Bruins turn it over, just short of the 40. Eric Ball with a good cut, great blocking, and was
State recovered.
On his way almost.
Watch the blocking to the right side of your screen. Number 40, Metcalf, gets pushed to the outside. Ball makes a good effort and just relaxes at the very end. Drops the ball, it's on the ground, and the Cougars cover it. Big play for the Cougars.
Marlon Brown, number 99, man on the ball, and Washington State now with an opportunity at the UCLA 37 after the turnover. Pass it in. 3 wideouts, bottom of the picture. Swinton goes to the top. That's 4 wideouts, and Rosenbach takes off down the sideline. And they give him the first down. He got just beyond the marker. And you got a Bruin very slow to get up. Number 66, that's Jim Waller, the UCLA nose guard, getting up very gingerly, hobbling. Something wrong with his left ankle or left leg, and Jim's going to have to leave the ball game.
Rosenbach came into the game averaging 71% completion, going for 18 touchdowns and only 7 interceptions.
Second and 10. Got some heat this time. Gets loose. He's got another first down. So both quarterbacks running a lot today. Clock stops at 7:24 to go in the third quarter.
Rosenbach came into the game today averaging 8 runs per game, 8 scrambles, if you will, for over 300 yards. So it's a big part of their offense. And whenever you've got an offense that spreads their receivers and the quarterback that can run, it gives you extra problems.
Bruins 13-yard line, first down, Cougars. Swinton pops a tackle, and if he kept his balance, he's in the end zone, but he didn't. However, he's down close to another first down, but this time they pick up the contact with the ground and mark him at the Bruins 6, where it'll be first and goal, Washington State.
Well, that big turnover that the Cougars got on the fumble has really given some life to this team. As I mentioned, they've scored 28 points in every game, and 4 times they've scored 40 points or more, so they're used to scoring points.
Second down at about 3. Swinton again, and touchdown, Cougars. So they answer right back, and now we're getting ourselves into a circumstance where we've got a little bit of a ball game here, don't we?
Exactly what Terry Donahue didn't want. When we're on top of them, keep them down. It's a spread offense, but watch to the right side of the screen. That's Dyko, number 68. Utley is 60. Wellsan is 82, the tight end, all getting good blocks for Swinton, and it's a... It's an 8-point ball game, and if he makes the kick, it's down to 7.
Hanson's kick. Good.
Good.
At 6:45 to go in the third quarter, it's now a 27-20 UCLA lead. The Washington State scoring in the first 37 minutes and 25 seconds, they had 6 points, and now in the last 5 minutes and 50 seconds of the third quarter, they popped up with 14 points. Hanson kicks it off. Long kick back into the end zone. The Bruins run together, Wills and Brown, and there will be no return of that kickoff. From the 20, it's first down, UCLA now. Let's see if the Bruins can answer back, as the Cougars have popped up here with 14 points in the third quarter, and Aikman drops to throw it and goes deep with it. He's got a man absolutely wide open, Reggie Moore. I mean, Moore could have caught a cold. He was so alone out there.
Todd was a defensive back on coverage, and Moore just ran him deep, thinking it was a deep takeoff pattern, and he stopped and came back. And as you mentioned, he was open by 10 yards.
It's at the 41. Troy Aikman now 17 out of 22, 207 yards, and he's hit 11 straight passes. Go to the shotgun now on 3rd and 7. Goes for far and can't get it to it. Mike had broken free about 25 yards downfield, but by that time they're climbing all over Troy, and now it'll bring up 4th down, and Barkate comes in to punt for the 3rd time in the game. At 1:08 to go, 3rd quarter, 20-20 ball game, UCLA. Victor Wood is standing Barkate back on his own 15 to accept it.
Victor Wood back on the team for the Cougars.
Barkett's a good punter. Wood at the 16 and down right there. Good coverage as Marcus Patton got down in a hurry. Here comes Swinton. From the 16 to the 19, and Craig Davis gets another tackle. Boy, he's made a lot of tackles today at that inside linebacker position.
UCLA rotates their inside linebackers. Davis and Johnson start, but Klein and Argo also play a lot. In fact, those 4 are the leading tacklers. 4 of the top 6 tacklers on the ball club are the inside linebackers.
Second down, seven.
It's a flip situation. Here it comes. There he goes.
Whoa, I'll say there he goes. Nobody back there. Touchdown. No flags. Yard touchdown for Tim Stallworth.
Big play. There's nobody here in the middle of the field. UCLA comes up and shows their defense too quickly. They're blitzing these guys. Right here is Stallworth. He's just going to go down the middle of the field. The quarterback sees there's nobody in the middle. He knows he doesn't have a lot of time, but just give me a little time. It's a quick pass. He threw it 15 yards for a long touchdown.
And this crowd at the Rose Bowl has grown very quiet.
You can't do that. You can't show your defense that far ahead of time to establish a very good quarterback.
Hanson's kick is good, and with 12 seconds to play in the third quarter, you've got a tie ball game. Top-ranked UCLA 27, Washington State 27.
We told you that Washington State could score. Now watch. Watch the blue guys. All these guys are going to blitz right in here. Everybody's blitzing. Nobody's back here in the middle to help out. You've got everybody spread out. There's nobody in the middle of the field. The quarterback sees it. You got one-on-one down the middle of the field. Short, quick throw. You've got some speed. And Stallworth, who is the cousin of the former Pittsburgh Steeler wide receiver, John Stallworth, certainly knows how to get into the end zone.
Ooh, hello.
He's got six receptions today and two touchdowns. That gives him seven on the year touchdowns. He came in with 36 receptions, led this ball club. And this is a little bit of what Dennis Erickson brought with him to Washington State. This style of offense, spread. Score a lot of points. He also took it to Wyoming, stole it there, and Idaho.
Well, if they hadn't made all those mistakes in the first half, you might have a totally different thing. But at least they're even now at 27. And this is Sean Wills at the goal line. And he's one man away from really breaking it big. And that one man was Chris Moton. But still very good field position for the opening snap in this possession.
Big series of plays that last time when Washington State got that touchdown. UCLA coming out and just really showing them what they were going to do. They had been disguising very well for the most part of the ball game, and that time Rosenbach just read it. Sure, Donahue just telling him, all right, settle down. Don't try to get it all back in one play. No, we just need a score on this drive. Just take your time.
Brown carrying for UCLA, and a solid lick on the line. Third quarter is over. Both these Washington teams have been a problem for UCLA this football season. We've got 15 minutes to go in this one. We've got 15 minutes left, and we're even at 27. And UCLA owns the football, second down and 10, at their own 27-yard line. Washington State won that third quarter decisively. Troy Aikman back to throw. Gets his pass away, and it is caught up at the 43 by David Keating. And Aikman took a lick as he delivered the ball. But I mean, he had some sizzle on it and right on the money.
The stats after three quarters of play. Offense is pretty much the same. UCLA still with 10 minutes more in time of possession, but the third quarter alone, statistics really favored Washington State, having come back and really scored 21 points to UCLA's 7.
Third down and 8 for UCLA. Aikman with a deep drop. Comes it down the middle. Pass is caught by Reggie Moore. Having a big day. First down, Washington State, 26-yard line.
UCLA. Don't panic. It's a critical play. Let's pick up the first down, and Aikman hits Reggie Moore. Moore came into this game with five straight games, but he had caught three or more passes. Today he's caught six for 75.
Ryan Brown is the tailback. It's his series. You've got three good ones. You've got to give him some playing time. This is Brown breaking it big. Ryan is down inside the 15-yard line. The old red R-back theory with the Celtics has been said a million times. You gotta know how many points it takes to keep them happy.
Terry Donahue was saying about his three fine running backs. He says it's like winning $1 million in the lottery. So that's the good part. The bad part is you have to pay taxes on it.
That includes me, to be perfectly honest with you. Third down and eight. Aikman. Good protection and the pass incomplete. Arbuckle was out there, but so was somebody else. Who was the other man out there? Brown?
Yeah. He was going. Yeah, he was going for Arbuckle.
Was he?
Expected.
It looked like Arbuckle. Didn't he pull away from
it? That's the problem. Arbuckle just pulled up to the bottom left. The bottom receiver is going to go down and break to the outside. The tight end is going to come down and break out. Now watch him, he's doing it for Arbuckle. Arbuckle just stands there.
He pulled himself away from it thinking Brown was gonna make the catch.
Yeah.
Velasco with a 30-yard field goal try now to give the Bruins the lead. Plenty of leg and it's good. At 11:39 to go in the ball game, the Bruins are back on top by a score of 30-27 as Velasco hits the 30-yard field goal. At the Bruins, Kirk Maggio will kick it off. Deep people for Washington State. Victor Wood 13 and C.J. Davis number one. UCLA leading 30-27 with 11 minutes and 39 seconds to play in the game. Maggio's had a good day. Kicking off, he's kicked it deep each time and high. It's Wood at the two. After about the 21. All right, here comes Washington State now. The crowd trying to get back into the ball game and make a little noise down there as the Cougars will come up. Rosenbach has now thrown 20 touchdown passes in a season, and he ties Jack Thompson's record at Washington State. Jack, of course, being the throw-in Samoan. Swinton wriggling around, finding some daylight. And he moved very well, carrying Steve Mayer on his back for the better part of 7 yards. And they have marked him short of the first down. Swinton now, who gained 193 yards last week against Arizona State, has 81 today on 19 carries.
And Swinton is a tough runner, runs a lot north and south, doesn't run, doesn't dance and juke around much, just gets upfield and lowers his head and gets what he can. No short yardage offense here, third and one. They still got the spread in with only one running back.
There's your first down as Rosenbach keeps it and moves it to the 47-yard line. Stanford, Washington. And it might got to be getting late in the fourth quarter now with Indiana leading Iowa by 11. Rosenbach back. Wants to go down the middle and nobody there. Now it takes off. And that's a penalty flag. He gets his first down on that when he's hit out of bounds by Carnell Lake.
That's a frustration foul more than anything else. As you take a look at the end of the play, that's just frustration right there. Clearly a foul. You know, we mentioned that the Cougars are the most penalized team in the Pac-10. Well, UCLA is right there with them. They have they're eighth in penalties in the Pac-10. UCLA today has seven penalties for 80 yards.
Well,
the thing that's frustrating when you watch a team in the seventh or eighth week of the season to be making little mistakes like the Cougars were making, procedure calls in the first half, and it hurt them on two occasions. Rosenbach gives it to Sweatin. He's still turning. And on first down from the just inside the 23, he carries the ball down inside the 17.
Last week, UCLA, Troy Donahue, the first time they had been ranked number one in a long, long time. And I think there's a special kind of pressure that goes with a number one team. You know, Miami has been ranked number one for so long, and Oklahoma, they kind of get used to it. But I think you hang that number one on a new team, I think they get the feel a little bit differently than they do without.
Yeah, and every guy that comes to town's all jacked up, too, isn't he?
Yep.
What? They go back to Sweatin again, and Sweatin trying for the first down. He had to get inside the 13. And it appears he's inside the 12. And it is the first down.
Correct myself. I mean, Terry Donahue, yeah. Not Troy.
Yeah, you'll get Troy's attention. Yeah,
I'm sure that Terry says that's all right because they take that quarterback name any time.
30-27, UCLA leading by three, 7:18 to play. Sweatin leads again over the left side and gets good help from Maholski and Husby. And they're down to about the five. They're chipping off some yardage now on first down runs, Bob. Look at that. There's another. That's 7 yards.
They're doing it with their offensive line, their big offensive line, and their power running with a one-back set. As I mentioned earlier, I've never seen a team, Dennis Erickson's team, with a stronger running game from a one-back set.
Sweatin has 106 yards now on 24 carries. Rosenbach keeps it, pulls it down, and takes off to the corner, and he's down to about the one. That'll be, I think, the first down.
Matt Darby making tackle.
Matt Darby made that tackle there, but that's the first time today I've called his name. Number 43.
It's a counterplay. Both of the linemen go the opposite direction. Now he bootlegs it back. Nobody is open downfield. He just gets as much of it as he can. Now Darby, 43, is going to come in right at the end to make sure he doesn't get into the end zone.
So it is first and goal from the one, Washington State. Sweatin, touchdown. My goodness, they made it look easy. And the Cougars have gone back to the lead.
You're right, they did make it look very easy. And as I mentioned earlier in the ballgame, this is only the second time all year, or now the third, that Terry Donahue and the Bruins have been behind.
And here is a very big point right here. If this extra point is successful, it's a 4-point lead rather than three. 6:21 to play in the game. It's good. So the nation's number one football team with 6:21 to play is behind 34-30. Well, Dennis Erickson right there could be about to breathe the richest moment of his football coaching career. But this man, Terry Donahue, he watched his Bruins come back against Washington and win it late. And looks like they're going to have to do it if they are to win against Washington State. Not so good. And I thought the Bruin defensive people looked a little weary.
I think that is what's really concerning Terry Donahue, is the fact that his defense has not stopped the Cougars in the second half.
Hansen kicks it off high, hangs up there. And it's Brian Brown. Fumbles the ball. Washington State's got it at the UCLA 37-yard line. Recovered by the kicker, Hansen. And Brown is down and out on the field. Now getting up just ever so slowly.
return, and Brown has got some good yardage. Right there, the ball is stripped free. Good tackle.
You know, I think Brian Brown, as I'm watching him, while you watch the replay go off the field, I think he's got a separated shoulder. It looks for all the world like that. And the kicker, Hansen, freshman from Spokane, comes down and covers the ball. The football is resting at the UCLA 19-yard line in the possession of Washington State. It is third down and four, and 34-30, the Cougars lead. Rosenbach to the corner of the end zone, incomplete.
Rosenbach's mad.
Look at Hansen into the ball game, the place kicker. He's kicked a 48-yarder, he's kicked a 51-yarder, and now he's got a chance to make it a 7-point Washington State lead with this effort. And at 3:20 to play, that would force UCLA, if they could score, to go for two.
A lot more pressure on
36-yarder. Missed it. Hooked it left. True freshman out of Spokane, Washington, a 48 and a 51-yarder. Now a 36-yarder to really put the heat on the Bruins.
I think he felt more pressure on that 36-yard field goal than he felt on those longer field goals at the beginning of the ball game.
Don't get all moaning and groaning. As a true freshman, he's going to be 17, 18 years old.
It reminds me of when Donahue and the Bruins were down to Washington in the late in the fourth quarter.
Very much the same.
And Aikman brought him back for a touchdown.
Trojans now moved out to a 20-point lead against Oregon State. All right, here it is from the 20 with Eric Ball back in at the tailback spot. And Aikman back to throw. And first down goes to the tight end, Randy Austin. And Austin is up near the 30 and could have a first down for the Bruins.
Austin is limping a little bit and is asking to be taken out of the ball game. He's caught 5 for 66.
David Keating comes in as a receiver, replacing him. Here's where Poise takes over. Senior Poise, perhaps. 3:05, clock running. Aikman back. Steps away from the pressure, pulls it down and dives across the 35 to get the better part of 6 yards. But it looked like he might get trapped and sacked. He squirmed loose.
What you have is the number one offense in the Pac-10 against the number 10, the last place defense in the Pac-10.
Better hurry up right here, too, or they're going to get nailed at the clock. Cut it off just in time. Pass is caught across the 40. That'll be a first down. Eric Ball out of the backfield. Went way up to get it. You can really get your bell rung when you're stretched out like that to catch a pass, but got away with it. Clock stops now. When you get to 2 minutes in college football, you get inside that to move the chains to save the time for you. Aikman. Across the field, hits his man right on the numbers. Drilled him.
And David Keating. How appropriate, Keith. You've got the man that is a favorite to win the Heisman Trophy, the top award in college football, leading his team down the field to score the winning touchdown.
Just short of the 45 of Washington State. Aikman again, sideline pattern incomplete this time. And it was intended for Mike Farr. So that stops your clock at 2:04. And just short of the Washington State 45, second down, 10. UCLA with 27 first downs in the game. Washington State, 26. Right now, the Cougars are leading 34-30.
Aikman doesn't like the shotgun, one of the few times he's been in it this year.
Intercepted. Yes. Intercepted by Artie Holmes. That time the defender went down on the grass and scooped it up, intended for Mike Farr.
That was picked off by number 19, Artie Holmes.
Take a look from the end zone. The problem with the shotgun, you have to look down to get the ball and then come back up top of your screen, the middle, Artie Holmes. Number 19 reads his eyes and comes and makes the interception.
And Washington State, with a minute and 59 seconds to play in the ball game, owns it just beyond their own 37-yard line. An incredible upset potential at hand.
Here's the interception. He was trying to get the man in the middle of the field. Now watch Holmes, this right here. He's going to drop back and then come up and make the interception. He doesn't like the shotgun because he has to look down to catch the football. You lose sight sometimes of where the defense is. And a little frustration right here at the end by Minifield.
Got away with it.
Well, the Bruins need a turnover, and they've not been good at turnovers this year.
1:59 to play. First and 15, Washington State. This is not your typical ball control offense. Rich Swinton, he's had a good day, a big day, tough day running for Washington State, and may very well have been the surprise of the game, though he just really surfaced last week with his 193 yards against Arizona State. The question is, can Washington State control the football on second down and 14? Rosenbach rolls it out, goes back the other way, now gets a little help up the middle, almost dropped the football, and gets back to about the 39-yard line. Here is the 81-yard touchdown play. Rosenbaugh to Stallworth that resulted in a 27-27 tie as Washington State scored 21 points in the third quarter. UCLA led in the ball game at halftime 20-6. And this is the touchdown here that put Washington State in front. Rich Swinton off the right side, and that gave the Cougars the lead.
What they're talking about is that they're getting a good play, but they're also saying, don't fumble the ball, don't turn it over. At worst, we want to punt it away and force UCLA to go the entire length of the field with probably less than a minute and a half to play.
With Swinton in motion, they've got four wideouts, and Rosenbaugh takes off. And I think there they were conceding rather than take any kind of risk. They will punt the ball away, and another Cougar getting up, hobbling off the field. Number 68, that's Chris Dyko, the offensive right tackle.
UCLA leads the conference in punt returns, and Washington State is the worst team in covering punts.
Darrell Henley.
Could it be?
Yeah, they got 10 Bruins up. And Henley ever so dangerous, back deep. 1 minute. They're letting the clock run. They'll take the 5-yard penalty. Myers, the Washington State punter today, 32-30. 33. He had one big one. His third punt of the day was a 55-yarder.
Good ball. The rule of the game against the offense.
still fourth down.
So now Darrell Hindley moves up across the 30. He acts up the front.
Decision here, do you try and block it?
Well, the Bruins change their mind.
Return it.
Field a couple of guys back to help. And the kick, not very long. Hindley's going to take a shot at it. Has a hole. One man. And they get him. He had one guy to get, and he couldn't get past him. Chris Moton finally pulls him down, and UCLA with 44 seconds owns the football at the Washington State 44.
Look to your left for blue shirts to try and form a wall. A lot of blue jerseys there. Right there, a nice block.
Right there was the man that forced it to turn back inside, and that was the difference. 31-yard return. All right, 44 seconds. UCLA has one timeout remaining. Troy Aikman steps up. They have no timeouts remaining. The scoreboard shows it, but that's wrong. Aikman down the middle. Arbuckle! The 10, the 6-yard line. The clock stops with 36 seconds to play in the ballgame. Charles Arbuckle. A 33-yard gain. Aikman throws it in the ground to kill the clock at 32 seconds. So they obviously don't have a timeout remaining. Dave Burnson right again.
This is the play previous. Arbuckle just going across your screen. Aikman does a nice job of looking to his right, keeping the safety out of the middle of the field. 29 is Todd, a corner, gets back in time to help pull Arbuckle to the ground. You want dramatics, how much better can you get? The Heisman Trophy leading candidate bringing his team down.
Trying to stay undefeated. Notre Dame won their game today, 22-7 at Navy. They didn't exactly blow the middies away. UCLA right now fighting for his life.
I've got three plays to get it in. First of all, I can't turn it over. Secondly, I don't have to throw it into the end zone here. I can throw it short if I have to.
From the 6, second down and goal. Incomplete. The pass intended for Arbuckle, and Artie Holmes, who had the big interception for Washington State, was right there to slap it loose.
Now this changes a little bit. You're on third down, and you almost have to throw it into the end zone, because if you throw it short and don't get out of bounds, the clock will continue to run. It'll be a hurry-up situation on fourth down, so you better throw it into the end zone on these two plays.
They've got 30 seconds. Two more plays. Field goal is useless. It's 34-30. Washington State leads.
Got to get him outside the pocket. Roll him out to the right.
Pressure. Gets it off into the end zone. Incomplete. Intended for Maury Toy out of the backfield, the fullback Ron Lee. But Aikman was just splattered after he released the ball.
He never sees the man coming from his right side, and he just does get rid of the football.
Bob O'Neill. 41. Here it is, fourth down and goal at the Washington State 6. Fourth down.
Nope.
Incomplete in the end zone. Incomplete, intended for David Keating, and Vernon Todd slapped it away and almost intercepted it. And Washington State takes over at their own 6 with 20 seconds to play in the ball game and leading 34-30.
Take another look. They were trying to get a pick. The two outside guys come in. The inside guy goes out. 29 is Todd. Does a nice job of finding his way through the traffic. Read the play the entire way and gets out there and breaks it up. Had no chance. He wasn't even close to being open.
And so now all the Cougars have to do is snap it one time. And this game will go down as one of the most stunning upsets of this football season. UCLA cannot stop the clock. Washington State has not won against the Bruins in Southern California since 1958. But today, they have. Washington State defeats number one UCLA 34-30. For Dennis Erickson, one of the biggest wins of his young coaching life, and he is now with Mike Adamley.
Keith, I don't think it's one of the biggest wins. I think it is the biggest win of your coaching career. Has to be, Coach.
Well, no question about it. It's amazing. We came out in that second half, and they scored first, and then our guy just came back. And after that loss last week to Arizona State, I just can't say enough about that football team. It's unbelievable.
You're down 20-6 at halftime. What do you tell your kids? And it was obvious that the defense was on the field far too long.
Well, they hit us with some double eagle blitzes that we weren't quite ready for, and so we made some adjustments and got some big plays off of it. And our defense came out and got the ball back, and we played offensively like we were capable of, and it's biggest win I've ever been involved in my life.
You were saying when you were a little kid you were watching game films at the age of 7 instead of cartoons. I guess Pinky, your dad, has a lot to do with that.
Your dad. Well, it was fast break football on turf today.
Today belongs to the Washington State Cougars. Dennis, congratulations. Enjoy it. Keith?
The old bell will ring in Bryan Hall all night long, I would think. 51,970 watched it. And this was the final guess for victory for UCLA. And it really never had a chance of succeeding. And so you have watched one of the big upsets of this season. Final score, Washington State Cougars 34, UCLA Bruins 30.